quite emotional to say bye-byes, and it's been wonderful being with you guys.
We love you, Karthik.
We love you.
All right, bye-bye.
Wow, that's a pretty emotional moment, ladies and gentlemen. Give it up for this gentleman here. Zordar Thalia. Okay, so we you know, public demand hai. एकदम अभी नहीं जाने दे सकते हैं सो क्विकली इफ यू वांट टू शूट अ कपल ऑफ क्वेश्चंस फॉर कार्ति सर हो जाए वेयर आर वी टेकिंग द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम देयर ठीक है वी डू दैट प्रमोशन मोड ऑफ द फिल्म Come. Yes, come on. Go ahead. Can we do it like a little quickly? Yeah. Lovely.
Any questions for Karthi?
No. No. We want you to answer a couple of questions. Vikram sir.
Thank you. We have beer. We have. Who needs a mic? Any money, sir?
Cool. Thank you so much.
Three of us. Come.
On your right.
Thank you guys. Thank you. Karthi, मेरा सवाल आपसे एक है. इस फिल्म में
talking as you walk करते
do that
इस फिल्म में आपको दिलों का राजा कहा गया है उसको आप किस तरह से डिफाइन करते हैं अपने कैरेक्टर के साथ दिलों
का राजा subtitles please
अदर द
सॉरी
किंग ऑफ हार्ट्स
can you talk about being the king of hearts
king of hearts oh, it's written so well so beautifully written the one liners are fantastic and it's not so difficult to romance these beautiful ladies also no you don't have to really try hard it naturally comes when you look at them and then of course when I overdo it Mani sir is there to control me so I look more charming you know I don't overdo it and stay cool you know sometimes I get to just get excited too much looking at them but then sir keeps me on control and then you should remember that Raman sir is playing music for me behind so all my look becomes even more better because of that music so I think all king of hearts are sitting here actually I'm trying. I'm not getting good marks there. I'm trying because Raman sir is not getting music for me exclusively. I'll take
a
track personally
CD.
And play it at home.
Cool.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Karthi sir. Thank you so much. Zordar thaliya ho jaye. Come on for this gentleman here.
Bye pa. Safe landing.
Best of journey, Karthi sir. Ye humne kisi ko nahi bola hoga na yahan pe. All right. So yeah, it's over to all you wonderful people. Ji, kahan se aa raha pehla sawal? Yes, you want to?
Huh. I have can I ask?
Yes.
Here.
Yes, ma'am.
Hi. A very warm welcome to this cast to Bombay. My question is for our Chiyan sir and Aishwarya. So like everybody spoke about that you know how you enlightened us with the knowledge about Indian heritage as is a beautiful piece of literature. What is your favorite part from this literature?
I love the unrequited love between Nandini and Aditi Karikal, and I think it's a very very different kind of love. I have romanced a lot of people in a lot of movies. It's always been one-sided love, or you love both of it's mutual. But this is the first time that there's one person who loves him so much he can kill him, and there's this other person who loves her so much he can die for her. And what happens then? I know. Does he die because of her? I don't know. Or does he live? You don't know. That is a very beautiful thought. And in the book too, it almost has an, it's not finished. It's left there for us to conjure up some image in our minds. And Manisa has wrapped it up so beautifully and I just love it. And working with her was phenomenal. I loved it. And once again, it was nice sharing screen space and that chemistry with her.
I completely echo his sentiments. And who better than to actually bring that kind of dynamic on celluloid than Manigaru? he is king of bringing romance into the most tense moments in, in a manner which is just so unique to his storytelling, his way of bringing magic, that pain becomes beautiful. You see love, you see intensity and the ultimate romance in the moments that, when written on paper, does not read like that, but is definitely experienced like that. And we're so fortunate to have had the, to have that creative opportunity to live those moments. Thank you. It's truly magical.
I have an extension to this question for you, Aishwarya. How did you get into the space of Nandini, who's smitten everyone? You know, now when it was on screen, there was a sense of proud, that, yes, this is someone right here. So how did you get in space,
Isn't that amazing? First, to begin with, in Kalki Sa's writing,
yeah,
that this lady is just so, the way she's been written in as a character, as a personality, it's just amazing that all the women also in the audience, apart from, the readers to begin with, absolutely love this character. There's a strange relatability, because I think deep down, all of us know that we are gray. It's not black and white. Everybody is gray. Everybody is layered as a personality. And that's just the deepest truth. So in life, actually, there are no labels. There is no compartmentalization about being a protagonist or an antagonist, or are you positive or are you negative. These are all labels that I think we as people go about attaching to personalities. We all have all the aspects and all the dimensions, and we're reactionary. So a lot of what we do and who we are and how we, it's so often reactionary. It's very and most often emotional. The triggers are experiences, and very deeply emotional experiences. And that's what so often can be the driving force for choices that you make in your life. And I think that's the core that makes her so relatable. And when Mani Garu narrated the film to me and said, Nandiniya, oh my God. I was like, really? I love it. He's a man of, we all have said this all day, man of few words, which you'll just also experienced. But that one word is enough. You know, he'll say one word, a look and a nod, and that even that little that follows. You know, there's so much said in that. It was just a natural yes, and I'm so, so thankful I got to essay his Nandini and be a part of this amazing, magical, immensely memorable, and personally very deeply treasured movie experience for me as an artist and each and every one of us here. So eternally grateful that I got to be his Nandini. His Nandini. Thank you, sir.
A.R. Rahman. मेरा सवाल आपसे है आपके हमने सॉन्ग्स इसमें सुने हैं और ख़ास तौर पर गुलजार साहब हैं तो क्या कहने बहुत बहुत मेस्मराइजिंग और बहुत अच्छा म्यूज़िक मैं आपसे एक सीरियस सवाल इसलिए करना चाहती हूँ कि हाल ही में अभी हमने एक साउथ की बहुत बड़ी माइथोलॉजिकल फिल्म देखी ख़ास तौर पर उसे कालिदास जी ने लिखा था और हमारे नॉर्थ बेल्ट के हैं तो हमें उसमें जो जो उनका उसका लिरिक्स था वो हमें थोड़ा सा कमज़ोर लगा तो हमने उनसे पूछा तो उन्होंने कहा कि लिपसिंग के प्रॉब्लम की वजह से ऐसा होता है क्या आप एज अ म्यूज़िक डायरेक्टर मानते हैं क्योंकि आप की जो ये जो हम अब सॉन्ग सुन रहे हैं वो बहुत अच्छे हैं और उसकी लैंग्वेज भी उतनी अच्छी है तो ये करना डिफ़िकल्ट होता है क्योंकि एक तो हिस्टोरिकल फिल्म दूसरा कि उसमें जो जो वर्ड्स होते हैं वो बहुत डिफिकल्ट और उसके साथ म्यूजिक को एडजस्ट करना मुश्किल होता है
I have been fighting this battle from Roja actually you know when I used to do jingles I used to have Hindi and Bengali and Tamil and Telugu so that actually gave me the experience to handle Roja with three languages so we all the lyric writers actually when it goes from one language to another language there are a lot of challenges within the challenges, we have super hits like Bombay and, you know, Roja. And from Dilse, Tamil, you know, Dilse was a Hindi movie. So we do have those limitations, but I think people are people are intelligent enough to understand certain limitations they see with the vibe. And beyond all this, there is an inherent quality with the lyric writers, whether it's even Mehboob or Gulzar Saab or Javed Saab. I think they come up with something which is believable and emotional, and which actually enhances the film. And having people like, you know, Gulzar Saab is actually a blessing for this one, because he doesn't look at a language. It doesn't divide this language as Hindi or Urdu or anything. He just brings an experience to us. And we trusted him, that's it.
मेरा सवाल ऐश्वर्या से है. ऐश्वर्या है. इकबाल फ्रॉम ANI.
हेलो.
हेलो. मेरा सवाल आपसे ये है कि जिस तरह का आपका और मनी सर का रिलेशन, एक विश्वास का कहें, प्यार का कहें, कॉन्फिडेंस का कहें, दिखता है पर्दे पर, पर्दे के पीछे भी. जब मनी सर की फिल्म आपके पास आती है तो वो सिर्फ नाम ही काफ़ी होता है या कहानी, किरदार, उन सब को भी आप ढूंढती हैं, देखती हैं?
गुरु भक्ति, गुरु है मेरे. तो मतलब एक तो सबसे पहले इट्स अ नेचुरल यस. हाँ तो है ही. जब भी हिंट हिंट सर जब भी पूछेंगे ज़रूर जवाब हाँ ही होगा. दैट्स अ गिवन. अब उसे श्रद्धा कहें, गुरु भक्ति कहें, कृतज्ञता कहें या प्यार कहें, you can label it what you want, but the point is that it would always be a yes. But why wouldn't it be a yes? I'm very fortunate. I think anybody, any actor, you speak to anyone who has had the opportunity to work with him or who hasn't as yet, deeply aspires to work with him. Actors and all creative forces, बहुत excitement रहती है. पता नहीं कितने लोग दिखाते हैं या नहीं, लेकिन बहुत खुशी होती है, बहुत excitement होती है. आज when we were giving interviews earlier also, we were being asked and everybody said that if a message or even that name flashes on the phone or you, sir, now we are telling you directly, you cannot imagine the excitement. We have shared it unabashedly during interviews today in the day. बहुत खुशी होती है, बहुत excitement होती है. Or and everybody truly looks forward to getting the opportunity to work with him. Or mauka mile, so it is very deeply treasured. It is very, very really cherished, respected. It's a learning curve. It is an experience which is unique to itself, and it shows in the reaction of the audience, of you viewers. I mean, it's all good. So I mean, why wouldn't one say a natural yes? Lekin khubi inki hai ki it's so lovely. In fact, he said that to me recently when I was asking him, sir, how? I was asking him the context of others. You know, when we were just talking, I said, sir, sometimes you kind of wonder, should one take that call or not? You know, say yes or not. And I've never spoken to him about this before directly, and I did only very recently, after we finished Ponniyin, no, sir? And he just said the sweetest thing. He said, you know, which it's always been, be honest about how you feel about the character you're going to essay. Even if it is me, don't just say yes. I said, no, I mean, you've always brought something magical. Bhale Iruvar ho, Guru ho, Ravan, Ravanan or Rab, Ponniyin Selvan. I mean, you've always brought something magical. So it's a natural yes, of course. He said, but even then, you've got to be honest about how you feel about the character that you're going to go essay, because you are going to live that character and you're going to bring that character to life. There has to be an honesty and integrity and a commitment which runs beyond just, I'm going to say a yes, but of course. But I'm going to say a yes, but of course. I will always just say a yes, but of course. It's him. Everything else is already set. Everything else is already in place. Thank you.